It certainly is. And this is the first clash I can remember ever between Steve Cram, who's had such a marvellous season, and the Olympic champion Joaquim Cruz, who was number one in the world as well as Olympic champion last year. There's Joaquim Cruz, the giant Brazilian, only 22, wearing number 87. And what a lineup this is. For Morris of Brazil, fourth in the 1980 Olympic Games on the inside. Then Johnny Gray, the American record holder, runs in lane two. In lane three, Joaquim Cruz. Lane four, waving to the crowd, Sammy Koskai of Kenya. Lane six, Steve Cram. Actually, we've jumped to lane there. That's lane five, Steve Cram. Lane six is Rob Druppers of Holland, silver medalist in the World Championship. And then we've got two athletes together. 102 is Dave Mack of America, and there's Billy Conchella, number 98 of Kenya. They run together in lane seven. Barbosa waves his hand. He's in lane eight of Brazil. He's the 3-age champion, and Mayer of Switzerland right on the outside. But Steve Cram, never afraid to test himself, although this isn't his best distance. First 10 running lanes, and Bomaris has gone off very, very quickly. Also going past on the outside is Barbosa. And the two Brazilians are going to help the big man Cruz. So as they settle down, it's Bomaris on the inside. Johnny Gray of America is right up there. Barbosa is up there as well. And Barbosa got pushed there by Gray, who got cut off, and Gray goes right back into the pack. So it's Brazil 1-2-3, and they're clearly running as a team. Bomaris leads. Barbosa in second place. Cruz is third. Steve Cram cruising as well in fourth place. Johnny Gray is in fifth, the American record holder. Bomar is now 28, fourth in the Olympic Games, won by Steve Ovette in Moscow. He leads. Cruz goes second. Barbosa third. Cram four. David Mack five. In sixth place, Billy Conchella. And seventh is Johnny Gray. 50.61 is fast. 300 metres left, Brazil 1, Brazil 2, Great Britain 3, and they're going away. Still Bomar is in front, Cruz in second place, Steve Cram is third, Johnny Gray is four, Conchella is five. Approaching 200 metres, and the giant Brazilian must take it up now. The Olympic champion, number one in the world last year, strikes the front, stalked by the world record holder at 1,500 metres, the mile at 2,000 metres. Gray of America, their record holder, coming through too. Can Cram do it from here? Cruz is fighting hard. Cram is looking smooth, but Cruz is strong. And Cram's battling his way through. He's a yard clear. He's 2 yards clear. And Cram beats the Olympic champion. Cruz second, Gray third, and Conchella fourth. The time, 1:42.88, and having just retained, or seen his world record stand in the mile, he's just run the fourth fastest time at 800 metres in history. The competitor supreme. A marvellous piece of running. The Olympic champion is a proud young man. You could see him respond to the challenge. And for a moment, Cram wasn't making headway. But gradually, the gap began to grow. First an inch, then a foot, and once Cruz knew he'd gone, he settled for second place. But at the moment, Steve Cram, the Jarrow Arrow, as they call him, is unbeatable. In the end, he was going away. And when, well, it seems silly to talk about potential when an athlete has done as much as he has, but I wonder still how much more there is to come.
In this lineup, we've got an Australian, a New Zealander, three men from America, a man from Somalia, a Swiss, a West German, an Irishman, two Britons, a man from Spain, Gonzalez, and Khalifa from Sudan. Shows you the way they'll line up at the start. And Steve Cram has just been introduced to the crowd. Saw Seb Coe a few minutes ago, jogging around, looked very, very relaxed indeed. Steve Scott, the American record holder, being introduced. Sebastian Coe. John Walker is one of our 100 4-minute miles. Bessinghager, the European 5,000-meter champion from West Germany, the German record holder. Gonzalez there going up the track, 1:42, the Spanish record holder. Ilhart of Australia, their record holder, number four. So the introductions are pretty well completed. One or two names not been mentioned. James Mays, who's out there, the American 800-meter runner, who we expect to be in front in the early stages. And there's Ray Frin in the all red, the Irish record holder. And we know less than eight national record holders in here, as well as the world record holder and the world 1,500-meter champion. There are 13 athletes lining up. Sebastian Coe's world record, 3 minutes 47.33 seconds. It's a really tense atmosphere. And the Dream Mile has been well named. Cram and Coe next to the outside. Away they go, racing straight into this bend, and James Mays, as we expected, went off, and somebody's gone down right on the inside. It's number 71, crashes down, DeLees, the Swiss record holder, the man who fell in the Olympic Games and went out in the first round, about 3 metres from the line. He's walked off in disgust. Too many athletes, really, chasing that spot, looking for safety as they race into that first bend. And the first target, if it's going to be fast, Coe ran the first 440 yards in 55.23. Still Mays leading, Ilhart of Australia in second place. Seb Coe right up there. Gonzalez right alongside him. Just behind him is Flynn. A cramping clear of trouble on the outside.
And isn't this the problem of the pacemaker, David, where James Mays is set off, Hillard's the only man that's gone with him, Steve Cram is beginning to go, but if Mays goes too fast, they won't want to follow because the race is more important than the record. And that's absolutely true of the two British contenders, the main contestants here. They want the race more than the record, and so if that pacemaker, James Mays, who's gone off, has gone off too fast, then the record may not be on, but there's still one tremendous race to come.
Time for the first lap, just over 56 seconds. A bit slower than Seb Coe's first 440 yards. But Cramer's got himself involved in this race right away, and he's not letting the pacemakers get away either. So he's stating his case already. Looks to me as if Steve Cram is going to tackle this race from the front and say to Seb Coe and the rest, chase me, catch me if you can. So as they come around to complete two laps, Mays leads, Ilhart of Australia in second place, Steve Cram of Great Britain third, Bile of Somalia fourth, Coe of Great Britain fifth, and in sixth place is Gonzalez of Spain, seventh is Scott of America, eighth is Flynn, and ninth is Walker. 153.82 at 880 yards, and that is only just outside the pace that Coe hit the halfway mark in. Still Mays leading. Ilhart in second place, Cram is third. Seb Coe four. Gonzalez five. Steve Scott goes six ahead of Bile. As they come round now, with 1.5 laps to go, and the lap mark is showing two at the moment, but they're wrong. And James Mays has dropped out, of course. And so, Ilhart leads now, the Australian record holder. Cram in second place, Coe is stalking him in third place. Fourth at the moment is Gonzalez, the Spanish record holder. And fifth, the American record holder, Steve Scott. With John Walker improving, and so too is Flynn as they come round to the bell this time. And the time at the bell, 2:53.14. Coe's time, and he broke the record, was 2:51.9. So it's going to be a real last lap, but Cram has set out in pursuit. Coe is following him all the way. And it's the two Britons out in front. Gonzalez of Spain in third place, Scott is four, and the race between the four as they come round with 200 to go. And Cram is testing Coe. Can Coe kick off a fast pace like this? And Cram is going away. He's now 5 metres clear, and Coe is beaten. And Coe relaxes, he knows that Cram is away and gone. And the world champion, the European champion, the Commonwealth champion, the world record holder at 1,500 metres, majestically comes striding away. This time, is it to crack the world record? Yes, it is. 3:46.3. Gonzalez second, Coe third, Scott four. Bile 5, Water 6, Flynn 7, Khalifa 8, and Aragon 9. 3:46.3. The world record goes to Jarrow. And what a magnificent run. Well, the doubts have been expressed about tactics. It has been said that this man is predictable, but could you really predict that he'd be brave enough and bold enough to go away from a field of this class so early and run right away from it? And certainly for the old world record holder, well, he knew his days were numbered. He went right away, accepts defeat very graciously indeed. But in fact, Steve Cram ran the finish out of Coe. That lovely high-stepping action took him right away. And the form he's shown in recent weeks confirmed today. And this is a young man who is only 24. And you have to say now, he's answered every question that's ever been asked. Just imagine the sequence. To win the Commonwealth Championship, the European Championship, the World Championship, to break the world record at 1500 metres, and now to break the world record holder and beat him over the mile and set new world record figures. 53.2 for this last lap. And here he comes, bouncing down the track, and he knows beyond any doubt at this moment, he's not only won the race, but I'm sure he must have had time to look ahead and see the ticking clock at the end of the straight, and to know too that the world record holder at the Classic Mile, the world record at the Classic Mile was his. Gonzalez in second place, Coe slowing down third, Steve Scott in fourth place, and, well, Ron Pickering said a couple of weeks ago in Nice he'd seen the greatest 1500 metres race ever, but tonight in this mile, Cram was by himself and ran one of the great miles of history.